put out all my junk and he would come shopping. Whenever he passed by our house, you'll see my son has to stay along with every day. So I'm like, junk market. I think he inherited my trait. Anyway, so one day I put a white legs pantyhose egg. Everyone know what that is? Like, yes. You used to buy the pantyhose and the egg. And I filled it with sand. And I put it on my bed and it said, surprise. And I knew he would go for it. And he came in and he was like, surprise. I said, that's a surprise. What is that? And he said, buy it to find out. Well, he gave me his full allowance. And I said, we haven't shown yet. I think I never forgot it, and neither did I. So when Charlotte told me that my second book should be about the Annoying Siblings Club, I knew she was right. But I also needed another vehicle, and so I thought about when I was in seventh grade, and I decided to start Flying Comets Club, because I really needed money. I always needed money, really badly. And so I ordered 18 cases of chocolate from the Catherine by Chocolate Company, fundraising company. And back then, you could just order it and then pay when you sold it, not like today. And so a big truck pulled into my parents' driveway one day, way out in the country, 20 miles north of Utica. And they put a ramp down, and my mom's like, what the heck is that? And they started unloading these 18 cases of chocolate. And I said, don't worry, it's just a club I started. I had five members, and I gave them all their allotment of chocolate. We had 25-cent bars and 50-cent bars, and I said, you know, here's how much you have to sell. I have all my sheets from that time in my scrapbook. I did all the math. I said, here's what you have to sell to pay me the amount I need, and then you can either sell the rest or you can eat it. And we did really well. We were selling all the chocolate at school. And one day I was called into the vice principal's office. And he said, you know, you have this club. And I said, yeah, Flying Comets Club. And he said, well, what are you raising the funds for? And I said, well, it's for our own pocketbooks. Because I didn't think there was anything wrong with that. And he said, well, we can't sell on school premises. So we were allowed to sell on the bus. And we got rid of our inventory. So when you read the book, you'll find out that my character, who bought some of my treats, starts her own club, and she has a hard time deciding what to do with the money, and spends a little bit on herself. And so before I hand the reins over to my partner in crime, Mrs. Howie Beauty, she's the teacher. We love her. She's the teacher in all of my books, and it was, I think I was 6 months into the first book when I realized my teacher was actually Mrs. Shaw. And once I realized that, it made it a lot easier to write. She's very memorable, and I love to have her at these events with me to read, because she reads things I don't even write. And she kind of makes them as she goes along, and it's awesome. So I wanted just to point out a couple people. There's a girl in this book named Sharon, who, one thing I like to do when I write is I take people I love, I have to love them, and then I reduce them to 8 years old. Then they're really easy to write about. So Dessert's good friend Sharon is in this book, and some bad things happen to her, but she gets through it okay, and she's right back there. And there's a guy back there who's one of the students, Josh. Raise your hand. There's a girl named Easy Lou. Where's Easy Lou? Right there. And a guy named Jordan. And Charlotte. She's from there too. A woman, Maggie Greenwald, had to leave, but her husband Dave is here, and she has one or two really annoying lines in this book. She's going to want to find those out. I wanted to point out Julie Polly. Where did she go? She's the do like them. And thanks to Jenny Brown, who's one of my dearest friends, who's a big inspiration to me. Caitlin DeLouis is here from my publisher, Simon & Schuster.